there's something about a mask that is special. And for a performer, most people think that what the mask does is it decorates us and makes us pretend that we are whoever the person or the animal or the figure is. It's actually in ritual a little bit different than masks. When the performer puts on the mask, we want to disappear and we want to become the spirit of what we're portraying. So if we're being the buffalo or the snake, we want to become the spirit of that animal and to perform that spirit. And in a way, we kind of disappear, which is, as a performer, kind of really amazing and fun to do that. This is Erick Hawkins, and he was a dancer. You can see him here with Martha Graham. Most people know Martha Graham because she's like probably one of the most famous American modern dancers. She was kind of, we sometimes jokingly call her the high priestess of our modern dance here. And Erick danced with Martha, and he was very influential to her work, and especially her work with masks. That was something, he grew up in the Southwest, and so he had a lot of contact with the Native American culture of America, and he really loved it. And when he met Martha, all of a sudden she started to do kinds of work with masks, and also she did Greek works, you know, about Greek myths, and he was a scholar of Greek culture in Harvard. So it kind of made sense that he had a big influence on her. Then he left her in 1950 and went off to make his own company, where he continued making work. This is a dance history book. I danced with the Hawkins Company. I still dance with them and try to keep some of the works alive. This was a history book that I had when I was in college. And you can see that I'm wearing what he's wearing today. From the cover of the book. So this is the Erick Hawkins role. We're really lucky here at UNLV because the entire collection of Hawkins masks and costumes are now here on campus, where they can be preserved and studied and continue to be used. So I also want to just thank the Barrick Museum and Alicia, because I showed Alicia these masks and I said, I really want to get them out of the boxes and places where people can encounter them, and my students can step into the mass and dance the movement of them. And Alicia said, well, let's do something right away.
There's a Native American prayer that says, honor all that is sacred. Honor the earth that is our mother. Honor the sky that is our father. Honor our elders, our parents, and everyone who came before us. And honor every living creature that lives with us on this earth. Those that walk on two legs, those that walk on four, those that have wings and fly, those that have fins and swim, and those with many legs that crawl. Honor the plants and honor each and every rock, no matter how small. Learn to live together, learn to love one another, and learn to dance together in peace, in balance, and in harmony. This is a dance, Erick Hawkins, Plains Daybreak. It tells of the first day of creation, and on that day, we see many animals. There is the snake who slithers amongst the rocks and rests in the grass. There is the mighty buffalo who roams our great plains, majestic. And on this day, the first man, he wakes up and he sees that he is amongst the animals.